Welcome to SciTech AI Utopia. Today I am going to give you 30 reasons to abolish organic animal meat and embrace cultured or artificial meat instead. I honestly think we should abolish meat altogether, but whatever. I will first briefly talk about cultured meat and its importance. But before that, sorry for a little rant. I am vegetarian and I strongly believe meat consumption should be abolished, unless it is survival on the line, perhaps due to overpopulation. Sorry for a little rant here, but honestly, most humans look cruel culprit hypocrites to me. They are raising ethical issues over Neuralink tests that killed over 1,000 animals, but honestly, these monkey tests were necessary before going on for human trials, potentially saving a lot more valuable and relevant life and opening doors for utopian future. People raise ethical concerns while simultaneously kill millions of animals regularly for meat, making sandals and stuff like that. That is some strong hypocrisy right there. These ethical issue-raising humans, who are biggest enemies of science and technology development, are the ones who are real cruel culprits and hypocrites, not the ones testing on animals for a far better future. That is just my opinion and I strongly believe in that. I don't get along with most people anyways. So now, let us briefly talk about cultured or artificial meat. It is also known as lab-grown or cell-based meat and is crafted through a sophisticated process that combines principles of biology, tissue engineering and food technology. The intricate method involves several stages from obtaining initial cell samples to cultivating them into a final product that closely resembles traditional meat. The journey begins with a small biopsy or tissue sample taken from a living animal. This sample typically contains muscle cells, which are the primary building blocks of meat. These cells hold the genetic information necessary for muscle tissue development. The choice of the initial cell source is crucial, as it determines the characteristics and flavor profile of the cultured meat. Once the biopsy is obtained, scientists extract the desired muscle cells from the sample. These cells are then placed in a controlled environment, often referred to as a bioreactor. The bioreactor serves as an artificial incubation chamber where the cells can proliferate and grow. The nutrient-rich culture medium within the bioreactor provides the cells with the essential components needed for their development, including amino acids, vitamins, and minerals. As the muscle cells multiply, they start to form three-dimensional structures that resemble the intricate composition of natural muscle tissue. Mimicking the conditions found in the body, the bioreactor provides the cells with mechanical stimulation, encouraging them to align and organize in a way that replicates the structure and texture of conventional meat. The process involves a careful balance of various factors, including temperature, oxygen levels, and nutrient concentrations. Scientists monitor and adjust these parameters to ensure optimal cell growth and maturation. The goal is to create a product that not only mirrors the taste and texture of traditional meat, but also meets safety and quality standards. In some cases, additional cell types may be introduced to enhance the complexity of the cultured meat. For instance, the inclusion of fat cells contributes to the overall flavor and juiciness of the final product. By carefully engineering the cellular composition, scientists can tailor the characteristics of cultured meat to meet specific consumer preferences. Once the cultured meat reaches the desired maturity, it is harvested from the bioreactor. The harvested cells are then processed to form the final product, which can take the shape of burgers, steaks, or other familiar meat products. texture, flavor, and appearance are optimized during this stage to ensure that the cultured meat aligns with consumer expectations. The cultivation of cultured meat doesn't only focus on muscle tissue. Companies in the field are exploring the potential to replicate other components found in traditional meat, such as connective tissues and blood vessels. This holistic approach aims to create a product that not only satisfies taste preferences, but also captures the complexity of natural meat in terms of mouthfeel and overall sensory experience. While the process of producing cultured meat is intricate, it offers a promising alternative to traditional meat production. The controlled environment of the laboratory reduces the risk of contamination and disease transmission, addressing concerns associated with large-scale animal agriculture. Moreover, the resource-efficient nature of cultured meat production contributes to sustainability goals by minimizing land use, water consumption, and greenhouse gas emissions associated with conventional farming practices. As technology advances, the methods for producing cultured meat continue to evolve, presenting a transformative solution to the challenges posed by the current food system. Now let us talk briefly about cultured or artificial meat's importance. Cultured or artificial meat holds immense importance in the realm of sustainable and ethical food production, representing a paradigm shift that addresses pressing global challenges. This innovative approach to meat cultivation is poised to reshape the food industry, offering a range of benefits that span environmental conservation, ethical considerations, food security, and human health. One of the paramount advantages of cultured meat lies in its potential to significantly reduce the environmental impact associated with traditional livestock farming. Conventional meat production is notorious for its resource-intensive nature, requiring vast amounts of land, water, and feed. The environmental footprint of large-scale animal agriculture includes deforestation for grazing, water pollution from runoff and waste, and substantial greenhouse gas emissions, primarily in the form of methane from livestock digestion. Cultured meat presents a compelling solution to these environmental challenges. By cultivating meat in controlled environments, this technology requires less land, water, and feed compared to traditional farming. The reduction in land use is particularly noteworthy as it addresses concerns related to deforestation, habitat destruction, and biodiversity loss. Since cultured meat production occurs in bioreactors and laboratories, it minimizes the need for extensive grazing lands, contributing to the preservation of natural ecosystems. Furthermore, the greenhouse gas emissions associated with traditional livestock farming are a significant driver of climate change. Livestock, especially ruminants like cattle, release methane during digestion, a potent greenhouse gas with a much higher warming potential than carbon dioxide over a shorter time frame. Cultured meat production, being more resource efficient, has the potential to lower overall emissions, contributing to global efforts to mitigate climate change. Ethical considerations are another pivotal aspect of the importance of cultured meat. Traditional meat production involves raising and slaughtering animals ruthlessly on a large scale, often subjecting them to crowded and stressful conditions. Cultured meat eliminates the need for industrial-scale farming, thereby addressing animal welfare concerns. By starting with a small tissue sample from a living animal, cultured meat production avoids the ethical dilemmas associated with traditional slaughter. This approach aligns with the growing societal awareness of and concern for the humane treatment of animals, providing a more compassionate alternative for consumers. In addition to ethical and environmental benefits, cultured meat plays a crucial role in enhancing global food security. As the world's population continues to grow, the demand for protein is expected to rise significantly. traditional meat production may struggle to meet this escalating demand due to limitations in resources, land availability, and the potential environmental consequences of expanding agricultural activities. Cultured meat offers a scalable solution that can provide a consistent and efficient supply of protein without the constraints associated with traditional farming. By decoupling meat production from the constraints of natural resource availability, cultured meat contributes to securing a stable and sustainable food supply for the future. The importance of cultured meat extends to human health considerations. Excessive consumption of red and processed meats has been linked to various health issues, including cardiovascular diseases and certain types of cancer. Cultured meat production provides an opportunity to design meat products with healthier nutritional profiles. By controlling the inputs and environment in which the cells are cultured, it is possible to create meat products with reduced saturated fat and cholesterol content. This aspect of cultured meat aligns with the growing emphasis on promoting healthier dietary choices, addressing public health concerns associated with high meat consumption. Moreover, cultured meat has the potential to mitigate the risk associated with zoonotic diseases. Traditional livestock farming, with its high-density animal populations and close human-animal interactions, creates environments conducive to the transmission of diseases from animals to humans. The controlled and sterile environments of cultured meat production minimize the risk of zoonotic disease transmission, contributing to global efforts to prevent and manage infectious diseases. The economic implications of cultured meat are also significant. As the technology advances and becomes more scalable, it has the potential to generate economic opportunities from job creation in the burgeoning cultured meat industry to potential cost savings in resource utilization. Additionally, the reduction in the environmental impact of meat production can alleviate the economic burden associated with mitigating the consequences of climate change and environmental degradation caused by traditional farming practices. Despite these promising advantages, challenges remain for the widespread adoption of cultured meat. Regulatory frameworks need to be developed and refined to ensure the safety, labeling, and public acceptance of cultured meat products. Scaling up production processes to make cultured meat economically competitive with traditional meat is an ongoing area of research and development. Consumer perceptions and attitudes towards cultured meat also plays a pivotal role in its acceptance and adoption on a global scale. So, the importance of cultured or artificial meat cannot be overstated in the context of addressing critical challenges facing the global food system, from mitigating environmental degradation and promoting ethical treatment of animals to enhancing food security and improving human health. Cultured meat represents a transformative force with the potential to revolutionize the way we produce and consume meat. Now, let us talk about 30 reasons to abolish conventional meat and embrace cultured or artificial meat instead. Number 1. Environmental impact. Traditional livestock farming, particularly cattle ranching, is a major contributor to deforestation. In regions like the Amazon rainforest, large swaths of land are cleared to make way for cattle grazing. This not only destroys vital ecosystems, but also releases substantial amounts of stored carbon into the atmosphere, contributing significantly to global warming. The Amazon rainforest, often referred to as the lungs of the earth, plays a crucial role in sequestering carbon dioxide. When forests are cleared for cattle ranching, the carbon stored in trees is released into the atmosphere, intensifying the greenhouse effect. Moreover, the loss of biodiversity resulting from deforestation disrupts ecological balances, leading to cascading effects on local flora and fauna. Cultured meat production, on the other hand, requires significantly less land. Cells are cultivated in controlled environments, eliminating the need for vast expanses of deforested land. This reduction in land use directly addresses the environmental impact associated with traditional farming practices. Number 2. Resource efficiency. Conventional meat production is resource intensive, requiring large amounts of water and feed to raise livestock. For instance, a significant portion of global soybean production is dedicated to animal feed. This diverts resources away from direct human consumption and exacerbates issues related to water scarcity and land use. In regions like the American Midwest, vast monocultures of soybeans are cultivated to meet the demand for animal feed. This extensive agricultural practice often leads to soil degradation and nutrient runoff, impacting local ecosystems. Additionally, the large-scale use of water for both crop irrigation and livestock contributes to the depletion of water resources. Cultured meat requires fewer resources in comparison. The production process involves cultivating a small number of cells in a controlled environment, significantly reducing the need for extensive agricultural land and water. This resource efficiency not only addresses the environmental impact but also contributes to sustainable agriculture by redirecting resources towards direct human consumption. Number 3. Biodiversity preservation. The conversion of natural habitats into agricultural land for livestock farming poses a severe threat to biodiversity. In regions like the Cerrado in Brazil, which is a biodiversity hotspot, the expansion of soy cultivation for animal feed contributes to the loss of native flora and fauna. The Cerrado, known for its rich biodiversity, is experiencing habitat destruction as large tracts of land are converted into soybean fields to support the growing demand for animal feed. This disrupts the habitats of numerous species, including endangered ones, leading to population declines and potential extinctions. Adopting cultured meat over traditional livestock farming helps preserve biodiversity by eliminating the need for extensive land conversion. Since cultured meat production occurs in controlled environments, it minimizes the negative impact on natural habitats, allowing ecosystems to recover and maintain their biodiversity. Number 4. Reduced pollution. Traditional livestock farming contributes to air and water pollution through the release of methane and ammonia. Concentrated animal feeding operations are particularly problematic as they generate vast amounts of manure that can contaminate nearby water resources. In regions with intensive livestock farming, such as parts of the United States and China, the concentrated animal feeding operations house large numbers of animals in confined spaces. The concentrated manure produced in these operations often leaches into nearby rivers and groundwater, leading to water pollution. Additionally, the digestion process of ruminant animals releases methane, a potent greenhouse gas contributing to climate change. Cultured meat production offers a solution to this pollution challenge. By removing the need for massive herds and manure-intensive farming, cultured meat significantly reduces the release of pollutants into water resources. Additionally, since cultured meat production doesn't rely on raising livestock in crowded conditions, it helps mitigate methane emissions associated with traditional farming. Number 5. Land conservation. Large-scale animal farming, especially for grazing, leads to extensive land use. The expansion of pasture land often involves clearing forests, which not only contributes to habitat destruction, but also reduces the planet's capacity to absorb carbon dioxide. In countries like Brazil, the conversion of Cerrado and Amazon rainforest into pasture land for cattle is a major driver of deforestation. This not only releases stored carbon into the atmosphere, but also eliminates crucial carbon sinks that play a vital role in regulating global climate patterns. Cultured meats production in controlled environments significantly reduces the need for vast expanses of grazing land. This helps in preserving natural ecosystems, preventing further deforestation, and allowing existing forests to continue their role in sequestering carbon. The conservation of land is crucial for maintaining biodiversity and mitigating climate change. Number 6. Water conservation. Livestock farming, especially cattle ranching, is notorious for its high water demand. From providing water for the animals to irrigating feed crops, the industry contributes significantly to water scarcity, particularly in arid regions. In water-stressed areas like California's Central Valley, large-scale irrigation for feed crops and water consumption by livestock strain local water supplies. The inefficient use of water resources exacerbates the challenges of water scarcity, affecting both ecosystems and human communities. Cultured meat production requires considerably less water compared to traditional livestock farming. The controlled environment allows for efficient water use, reducing the overall demand on water resources. This shift supports water conservation efforts, particularly in regions facing water scarcity, and contributes to the sustainability of water ecosystems. Number 7. Global food security. Traditional meat production is often resource intensive and can strain global food resources. The allocation of grains and other crops for animal feed, especially in regions facing food scarcity, diverts potential human food sources to support livestock. In regions like sub-Saharan Africa, where food security is a persistent challenge, the use of grains for animal feed contributes to food scarcity. The demand for animal products can drive up the prices of feed grains, making them less accessible for direct human consumption. Cultured meat production offers a more direct and efficient way to produce protein for human consumption. By eliminating the need for extensive land and feed for livestock, cultured meat can contribute to global food security by channeling resources directly into human food production. Number 8. Human health. Excessive consumption of red and processed meats has been linked to various health issues, including cardiovascular diseases and certain types of cancer. In countries with high meat consumption, such as the United States, these health concerns pose significant public health challenges. In the United States, where red and processed meat consumption is widespread, there is a higher prevalence of health issues like heart disease and colorectal cancer. This has led to increased healthcare costs and a burden on public health systems. By encouraging a shift towards cultured meat, which can be designed with a focus on health considerations, there is potential to reduce the prevalence of diet-related health issues. Controlled production processes allow for the creation of meat products with lower saturated fat and cholesterol content, promoting healthier dietary choices. Number 9. Antibiotic resistance. The routine use of antibiotics in traditional livestock farming, especially in crowded and unsanitary conditions, contributes to the development of antibiotic-resistant bacteria. This poses a significant threat to public health globally. In countries like China, where large-scale pig farming is common, the widespread use of antibiotics to promote animal growth and prevent diseases has led to the emergence of antibiotic resistance strains of bacteria. This jeopardizes the effectiveness of antibiotics in treating infections in both animals and humans. Cultured meat production occurs in controlled environments that are less prone to disease outbreaks, reducing the reliance on antibiotics. This shift can contribute to the global effort to combat antibiotic resistance, safeguarding the effectiveness of antibiotics for human and veterinary medicine. Number 10. Animal welfare. Conventional livestock farming practices often involve crowded and confined spaces, leading to poor living conditions for animals. Factory farming, in particular, has been criticized for its impact on animal welfare. In the European Union, where intensive farming practices are prevalent, millions of animals are raised in confined spaces with limited mobility. This raises ethical concerns about the well-being of animals, as they may experience stress, injuries, and lack of natural behaviors. Cultured meat production has the potential to improve animal welfare by eliminating the need for large-scale industrial farming. In a controlled lab environment, cells are cultured to produce meat without subjecting animals to the stressful conditions of traditional farming. This shift aligns with growing concerns for ethical treatment of animals in food production. Number 11. Food safety. Outbreaks of foodborne illnesses linked to traditional meat products are not uncommon. Contamination during various stages of meat production, processing and distribution can pose serious risk to public health. In the United States, instances of E. coli and Salmonella contamination in beef and poultry have led to widespread recalls and cases of foodborne illnesses. These incidents highlight the challenges associated with maintaining food safety standards in traditional meat production. Cultured meat production offers a more controlled and sterile environment, reducing the risk of bacterial contamination. The closed systems used in labs minimize the chances of pathogens entering the production process, enhancing overall food safety. This aspect is crucial for public health and can contribute to a safer food supply. Number 12. Land use conversion. The expansion of agricultural land for livestock farming often involves converting natural ecosystems into areas dedicated to animal husbandry. This land use change can have detrimental effects on biodiversity and ecosystem services. In South America, particularly in countries like Argentina and Paraguay, the conversion of vast areas of the Gran Caco region into pasture land for cattle has led to deforestation. This process not only disrupts the habitats of native species, but also contributes to soil erosion and loss of biodiversity. Embracing cultured meat reduces the need for extensive land conversion. In a laboratory setting, meat can be produced without the large-scale clearing of natural habitats. This shift supports conservation efforts, helping to preserve biodiversity and protect ecosystems from the negative impacts associated with land use conversion. Number 13. Mitigating deforestation. Traditional livestock farming, particularly for cattle, is a major driver of deforestation in regions like the Amazon rainforest. The clearing of land for pasture not only contributes to the loss of biodiversity, but also releases large amounts of carbon stored in trees. In Brazil, extensive areas of the Amazon rainforest are cleared for cattle ranching. This not only disrupts the delicate balance of rainforest ecosystem, but also contributes to climate change as the stored carbon in trees is released into the atmosphere. Cultured meat production eliminates the need for vast expanses of cleared land. By growing meat in controlled environments, the demand for land-intensive practices like cattle ranching decreases, mitigating deforestation and its associated environmental impacts. Number 14. Lower greenhouse gas emissions. Livestock, especially ruminants like cows, produce methane during digestion, which is a potent greenhouse gas. Large-scale cattle farming contributes significantly to global greenhouse gas emissions. In countries like United States and Australia, where cattle farming is widespread, the methane emissions from enteric fermentation or digestion process of cows contribute to the greenhouse gas effect. Methane has a much higher warming potential than carbon dioxide over a shorter time frame. Cultured meat production generally results in lower greenhouse gas emissions compared to traditional livestock farming. The controlled environment allows for more efficient resource use, reducing the overall carbon footprint associated with meat production. This shift supports global efforts to combat climate change by lowering emissions from the agricultural sector. Number 15. Reduced wildlife impact. Traditional farming practices, including large-scale monocultures and extensive land use for livestock, can displace and harm wildlife. This impact is particularly evident in regions with diverse ecosystems, such as the African savannas. In African countries like Kenya and Tanzania, where wildlife coexists with agriculture, the expansion of farmland and ranching can lead to habitat fragmentation and increased human-wildlife conflict. Large herbivores, in particular, face challenges as their natural habitats are transformed into agricultural land. The adoption of cultured meat can alleviate pressure on wildlife habitats. With reduced land requirements, cultured meat production minimizes the need for encroaching into natural ecosystems. This allows for the preservation of wildlife habitats, contributing to the conservation of diverse species. Number 16. Economic efficiency. Traditional livestock farming involves significant economic costs, including feed production, veterinary care, and environmental cleanup. The economic burden can be particularly high in countries with large-scale animal agriculture. In the European Union, where intensive animal farming is common, the economic costs associated with livestock farming include subsidies for feed production, environmental mitigation measures, and healthcare expenses due to the impact of agriculture on human health. Cultured meat production has the potential to be more economically efficient. While initial setup costs for lab infrastructure may exist, the controlled environment and optimized processes can lead to streamlined production, reducing long-term economic burdens associated with traditional livestock farming. Number 17. Social justice. The distribution of resources in traditional meat production can contribute to social inequalities, particularly in access to land and water. This issue is evident in various regions, including parts of Africa, where pastoral communities depend on land for their livelihoods. In countries like Kenya and Tanzania, pastoralist communities rely on extensive grazing lands for their livestock. As demand for meat increases and competition for land rises, these communities often face challenges in maintaining their traditional practices and accessing sufficient resources. Embracing cultured meat can contribute to social justice by mitigating conflicts over land and resources. The reduced land footprint of cultured meat production allows for a more equitable distribution of resources, potentially benefiting marginalized communities that rely on the same land for their livelihoods. Number 18. Reduced landfill waste. Traditional meat processing generates significant waste, including animal byproducts and packaging materials. This waste can contribute to environmental pollution and the strain on landfill capacities. In countries with large-scale meat processing industries, such as the United States, the disposal of animal byproducts, excess fat, and packaging waste from meat products can result in substantial landfill waste. The environmental impact includes methane emissions from decomposing organic matter and the potential for soil and water contamination. Cultured meat production has the potential to generate less landfill waste. The controlled production process allows for more efficient utilization of raw materials, minimizing waste production. Additionally, advancements in packaging technologies for cultured meat could focus on eco-friendly and recyclable materials, further reducing the environmental impact associated with meat consumption. Number 19. Energy efficiency. Traditional meat production involves multiple energy-intensive stages, from growing feed crops to maintaining livestock, transportation, and processing. The energy demand throughout this supply chain can be substantial, particularly in countries with large-scale industrial farming. In the United States, where industrial-scale livestock farming is prevalent, the entire process of conventional meat production requires significant energy inputs. This includes energy for crop cultivation, transportation of feed, operation of machinery, and the processing and refrigeration of meat products. Cultured meat production has the potential to be more energy efficient. The controlled environment in which cells are cultured allows for optimized resource utilization. Additionally, as technology advances, there is potential for innovations that further reduce the energy footprint of cultured meat production, contributing to a more sustainable and energy-efficient food system. Number 20. Conservation of wild species. Traditional hunting for meat consumption can contribute to the decline of wild species, especially in regions where unsustainable hunting practices persist. This is evident in areas where traditional hunting for bush meat is a common practice. In parts of Central Africa, the demand for bush meat has led to overhunting of species like primates and ungulates. This has resulted in population declines, posing threats to biodiversity and the ecological balance of rainforest. Cultured meat can contribute to the conservation of wild species by reducing the demand for traditional hunting. As cultured meat becomes more widely adopted, the pressure on wild populations decreases, allowing for the recovery and conservation of species that are at risk due to overhunting. Number 21. Preservation of cultural heritage. Traditional meat consumption is often deeply intertwined with cultural practices and culinary heritage. The challenge arises when these cultured practices contribute to environmental degradation or ethical concerns. In countries like Japan, where whale meat has historical and cultural significance, the traditional practice of whaling has faced criticism due to concerns about the impact on endangered species and marine ecosystems. Cultured meat provides an opportunity to preserve cultural food preferences without the associated environmental and ethical concerns. For example, if cultured meat technology advances to allow the replication of specific flavors and textures associated with traditional dishes, it could offer a sustainable alternative that aligns with cultural practices. Number 22. Innovative technological advancements. Cultured meat production involves cutting-edge technologies that continue to evolve. Advances in biotechnology, tissue engineering, and cell culture techniques contribute to the innovation within the field. In the Netherlands, companies like Mosa Meat have been at the forefront of cultured meat development. This process involves extracting a small number of cells from a living animal and then cultivating these cells in a nutrient-rich environment to produce meat. This innovative approach represents a breakthrough in the intersection of biotechnology and food production. These technological advancements not only drive the efficiency of cultured meat production, but also have broader implications for biotechnological innovation. The development of scalable and cost-effective processes could extend beyond meat production, influencing fields such as regenerative medicine and bioengineering. Number 23. Adaptation to changing climate. The global climate is undergoing significant changes, impacting traditional agriculture and livestock farming. Cultured meat represents a potential adaptation strategy to mitigate the environmental challenges posed by climate change. In regions like Australia, where climate change contributes to more frequent and severe droughts, traditional livestock farming faces increased challenges. The scarcity of water and declining pasture quality impact animal welfare and productivity. Cultured meat production, being less reliant on environmental conditions, can be adapted to various climates. This adaptability allows for a more resilient and stable food supply, particularly in regions vulnerable to the effects of climate change. Number 24. Educational opportunities. The emergence of cultured meat provides opportunities for educational initiatives to raise awareness about sustainable food choices, ethical considerations, and the environmental impact of traditional meat production. Educational programs, like those initiated by organizations such as the Good Food Institute, aim to inform the public, policymakers, and industry stakeholders about the benefits of cultured meat. This includes highlighting its potential to address environmental issues, reduce animal suffering, and ensure food security. Increased awareness and understanding of cultured meat foster informed decision-making. Educational efforts create a pathway for consumers, policymakers, and future generations to make good choices that align with sustainability goals, contributing to a more conscientious and responsible approach to food consumption. Number 25. Crisis resilience. The traditional meat industry faces vulnerabilities during crises such as pandemics, as demonstrated by the challenges experienced in the meat packing sector during the COVID-19 pandemic. In the United States, major meat processing plants experienced outbreaks among workers, leading to closures and disruptions in the supply chain. The meat packing industry's reliance on densely populated processing plants created an environment conducive to the rapid spread of infectious diseases. Plant closures not only led to shortages of meat products, but also highlighted the fragility of the conventional meat supply chain in the face of unexpected challenges. Artificial meat production occurring in controlled environments such as labs is less susceptible to the risk associated with large-scale processing plants during pandemics. The decentralized nature of artificial meat production allows for continued operation with reduced exposure to disease transmission. This resilience contributes to a more stable and secure food supply chain, especially during global health crises. Number 26. Reduced agricultural runoff. Agricultural runoff from traditional meat production containing excess nutrients and pollutants contributes to water pollution and ecological damage. The Chesapeake Bay in the United States has faced challenges related to runoff from intensive poultry and livestock farming, impacting water quality and aquatic ecosystems. In the Chesapeake Bay watershed, agricultural runoff, including nutrient-rich runoff from animal waste and fertilizers, has led to algal blooms, oxygen depletion, and dead zones where marine life struggled to survive. The ecological consequences of agricultural runoff extend beyond the immediate farming areas, affecting downstream water bodies. Artificial meat production, being less reliant on extensive agricultural practices, reduces the environmental impact of runoff. The controlled environments in which artificial meat is cultivated minimize the use of fertilizers and the need for large-scale animal farming, thus mitigating the potential for nutrient runoff and its adverse effects on water quality and ecosystems. Number 27. Preservation of indigenous knowledge. Indigenous communities around the world often have traditional knowledge related to sustainable agriculture and animal husbandry. In regions like the Arctic, where indigenous communities rely on hunting and fishing for sustenance, the encroachment of modern industrial practices poses a threat to their traditional knowledge and way of life. Arctic indigenous communities, such as the Inuit, have a deep understanding of local ecosystems and sustainable hunting practices. However, the impact of climate change, resource extraction, and changes in animal migration patterns due to environmental shifts jeopardize the preservation of their traditional knowledge and food systems. Artificial meat production, by reducing the demand for traditional livestock farming, can contribute to the preservation of indigenous knowledge. As the pressure on natural landscape decreases, indigenous communities can continue practicing sustainable food production methods, maintaining their cultural identity and ecological harmony without the adverse impacts of industrial agriculture. Number 28. Revitalization of degraded land. Traditional livestock farming through practices such as overgrazing can lead to land degradation and desertification. Regions like the Sahel in Africa have experienced the consequences of extensive livestock grazing on once fertile land. The Sahel region has faced challenges such as soil erosion, reduced vegetation cover, and loss of arable land due to overgrazing by livestock. Land degradation exacerbates food insecurity, displaces communities, and intensifies the impact of climate change on vulnerable ecosystems. Artificial meat production can play a role in revitalizing degraded land by reducing the need for large-scale livestock farming. As the demand for extensive grazing areas decreases, there is an opportunity for ecosystems to recover. This shift contributes to the restoration of soil fertility, the promotion of plant cover, and the overall rejuvenation of degraded landscapes. Number 29. Promotion of sustainable protein sources. Overfishing is a significant threat to marine ecosystems, and traditional seafood production methods contribute to the depletion of fish stocks. The global tuna industry provides a notable example where overfishing and bycatch have raised concerns about the sustainability of current practices. Tuna, a highly sought-after species, faces severe overfishing due to high demand for canned tuna and sashimi. Traditional fishing methods such as long lining and pursue seining often result in bycatch, catching unintended species, including threatened or endangered marine life. The depletion of tuna populations and the collateral damage to other marine species highlight the unsustainable nature of conventional seafood production. Artificial meat, when designed to replicate the taste and texture of seafood, offers a sustainable alternative to traditional fishing. By cultivating fish cells in controlled environments, artificial seafood production avoids the environmental consequences of overfishing, bycatch, and habitat destruction. This promotes marine conservation and supports the transition to more sustainable protein sources. Number 30. Consumer customization. The traditional meat industry often provides limited options for consumer customization, with variations primarily centered around cooking methods and seasoning. In contrast, artificial meat technology opens up possibilities for tailored meat products to meet specific consumer preferences. In traditional meat consumption, consumers typically have limited control over factors such as nutritional content, flavor profiles, and specific dietary requirements. While cooking methods allow some customization, the inherent characteristics of the meat itself are largely predetermined by the animal's biology, breed, and feeding practices. Artificial meat production introduces a new level of consumer customization. By manipulating the composition of cultured cells, scientists can potentially offer a spectrum of options for consumers to customize their meat products. For instance, individuals with dietary restrictions or preferences for specific nutritional content can choose artificial meat with tailored protein, fat, or micronutrient profiles. Flavor profiles can be adjusted to suit regional tastes or personal preferences, allowing consumers to have a more personalized and satisfying meat eating experience. So, these were 30 reasons to embrace cultured or artificial meat instead of conventional meat. It is driven by the myriad of compelling reasons spanning environmental, ethical, health, and economic dimensions. One of the pivotal reasons advocating for the widespread adoption of cultured meat is its potential to revolutionize resource efficiency in agriculture. Traditional livestock farming, notorious for its extensive land use, water consumption, and feed requirements, contributes to deforestation, habitat destruction, and greenhouse gas emissions. Embracing cultured meat significantly reduces the environmental footprint by cultivating meat in controlled environments, minimizing the need for vast grazing lands, and addressing concerns related to biodiversity loss. Closely intertwined with environmental considerations is the pressing need for global water conservation, a challenge exacerbated by traditional meat production. In regions like California, where agriculture places substantial demands on water resources, the water-intensive nature of traditional livestock farming contributes to water scarcity. Cultured meat production offers a sustainable alternative with reduced water requirements, mitigating stress on water supplies and supporting conservation efforts in water-stressed regions. This paradigm shift underscores the broader impact of embracing cultured meat on sustainable agricultural practices and the responsible use of vital resources. Beyond environmental considerations, the mitigation of antibiotic resistance emerges as a crucial aspect of cultured meat narrative. Traditional animal agriculture relies heavily on antibiotics for growth promotion and disease prevention in crowded and stressful farming conditions. This widespread use of antibiotics contributes to the development of antibiotic-resistant strains of bacteria, posing significant risk to public health. The adoption of cultured meat, with its controlled environments and reduced reliance on antibiotics, aligns with global efforts to address the growing threat of antibiotic resistance, emphasizing the importance of safeguarding human health in the pursuit of sustainable food production. The resilience of cultured meat in the face of crisis, particularly highlighted by the challenges experienced in traditional meat processing plants during the COVID-19 pandemic, adds another layer of significance. The decentralized nature of cultured meat production, occurring in controlled environments and laboratories, reduces susceptibility to disease transmission and disruptions in the supply chain. This resilience not only contributes to food security during pandemics, but also highlights the potential for a more stable and secure food supply chain in the long term. Enhanced food safety monitoring emerges as a critical advantage of embracing cultured meat, addressing challenges associated with traditional meat processing and transportation. Instances of contamination and foodborne illnesses linked to conventional meat products underscore the importance of stringent safety measures. Cultured meat production, with its closed-loop systems and precise control over environmental conditions, minimizes the risk of contamination, offering consumers a safer and more reliable meat consumption experience. Moreover, the social and ethical dimensions of embracing cultured meat cannot be overstated. The humane treatment of animals in traditional meat production, often characterized by crowded and stressful conditions, has long been a source of concern. Cultured meat, starting with a small tissue sample from a living animal, sidesteps the ethical dilemmas associated with traditional slaughter. This aligns with evolving societal values and a growing awareness of the ethical treatment of animals, presenting consumers with a more compassionate alternative. Cultural adaptability further reinforces the case for embracing cultured meat, recognizing the diverse dietary preferences and practices across different societies. In regions where cultural or religious traditions discourage the consumption of certain meats, or where vegetarianism is deeply ingrained, cultured meat offers a bridge between cultural values and evolving dietary preferences. The ability to tailor cultured meat to suit diverse culinary traditions supports inclusivity and accommodates a spectrum of dietary choices. Preserving indigenous knowledge emerges as a unique aspect of cultured meat narrative, acknowledging the intricate relationship between traditional communities and sustainable food practices. The encroachment of modern industrial practices, often associated with large-scale agriculture, poses a threat to the traditional knowledge held by indigenous communities. Embracing cultured meat by reducing the demand for extensive livestock farming contributes to the preservation of indigenous practices, supporting both cultural diversity and ecological sustainability. Human rights and labor practices in traditional meat processing plants, notorious for exploitative conditions and safety concerns, are addressed through the adoption of cultured meat. The controlled and automated environment in which cultured meat is produced reduces the reliance on manual labor in harsh conditions, improving worker safety and overall labor practices. This shift aligns with broader societal goals of promoting fair labor practices and ensuring the well-being of workers in the food industry. The significance of embracing cultured meat extends to the realm of consumer customization, offering a level of control and personalization unprecedented in traditional meat consumption. Artificial meat technologies allow for the manipulation of cellular composition, enabling consumers to tailor the nutritional content, flavors, and textures of their meat choices based on personal preferences and dietary needs. This customization aligns with evolving consumer expectations for personalized and healthier food options, emphasizing the adaptability of cultured meat to individual lifestyles. The promotion of sustainable protein sources is exemplified by the environmental challenges associated with traditional seafood production. Overfishing and the depletion of marine resources threaten fragile ecosystems and food security. Cultured seafood, as part of the broader cultured meat movement, provides a sustainable alternative that alleviates pressure on marine ecosystems and supports the conservation of ocean biodiversity. Mitigating agricultural land use disputes is a unique contribution of cultured meat, recognizing the conflicts arising from the expansion of traditional agriculture. Indigenous lands, local communities, and natural habitats are often impacted by large-scale farming activities. Embracing cultured meat, with its reduced demand for extensive agricultural land, offers a potential solution to land use conflicts, supporting social harmony and ecological conservation. Advancements in cellular agriculture, exemplified by companies like Future Meat Technologies, underscore the ongoing evolution of cultured meat production methods. Bioreactor technology, scalable cell culture methods, and a focus on efficiency contribute to the development of cultured meat as a viable and accessible solution. The advancement of cellular agriculture represents a dynamic field with the potential to reshape the future of meat production. So, the comprehensive impact of cultured meat extends from the reduction of environmental footprints and the preservation of biodiversity to the enhancement of food safety, cultural adaptability, and social responsibility. As technology continues to advance and societal values evolve, the embrace of cultured meat emerges as a multifaceted solution to complex challenges facing the global food system. Embracing cultured meat becomes a pivotal step towards a more sustainable, resilient, and ecologically responsible future for the planet. Thank you very much for watching. And may we abolish the hypocritic, ruthless killing of animals for meat and embrace artificial meat instead. Also, the ones raising ethical concerns for animal testing are the real culprit hypocrites themselves and the biggest enemies of science and technology development. May we embrace the use of animals for laboratory tests and advancements in technologies for a utopian future of the planet. It is going to save far more important lives for millennia to come.